So LSA, Logistics Supportability Analysis, is a body of activities aimed at identifying what the resources are going to be needed in order to support the hardware, as well as identifying the basics of crew operator tasks, how to do it, the parts that will be needed, the tools that will be needed. And an LSAR, meaning record, captures all of that data such that the logistics organization is able to look across all of the hardware that's going into the program and identify common uses of tools, unique tools that are having to be developed versus the ability to use a common tool. It is identifying how much crew time is going to be needed in order to do maintenance, not only at an aggregate level, but also at an individual level, and identify which pieces of hardware are outliers. We used to call them bad actors, in that you would have a piece of hardware that, based on its predicted failure rate and the maintenance crew time, you were able to say, this is a piece of hardware that is going to be intensive to maintain, and the design team ought to take a look at what can be done to either improve the reliability or to make it more simple to be able to maintain. So all of those things get captured in that LSAR. That is done up front in the program and is iterated as the program continues to develop and goes through its various design milestones, PDR and CDR and so forth. On a traditional DoD program, the LSAR would then be archived, and there would be a group of tech writers who would come in and pull what they wanted out of the LSAR and turn them into tech manuals. We did not do that on this program. That was going to be additional costs that we realized wasn't going to be money well spent. So what we did is we took that body of data and we maintained it and we enhanced it such that it had the information in it that the mission operations directorate, the flight controllers, need in order to build the crew procedures for the crew to be able to maintain the station. So we skipped that entire build the tech manual step simply by enhancing the existing data we had. The beauty of it on a program like ours is, as the station continues to get maintained and sustained and gets various design changes and upgrades, those engineering changes then get fed back into the LSAR, which then get reflected in those maintenance procedures. So it greatly reduces any opportunity for error in the maintenance procedures that get handed to the crew, because the processes are in place such that you go from engineering change to engineering design to logistics supportability analysis record update to crew procedure, and that thread is continuous throughout such that you don't have somebody trying to develop a maintenance procedure trying to go dig through various engineering databases to try and figure out what the new design is. So that resource that we took from DoD, we took it and highly tailored it for our program, used it a little differently than DoD does, and it's become a body of data that we'll use until the end of the program to maintain the station. The lesson that we learned in that of doing an upfront assessment and then continuing to use that in the fashion that makes sense for your program is what you would want to do. It doesn't necessarily mean you would need to use the same mill standard data system that station did, but that using that data set because of its value, rather than, okay, development's over, I don't need that anymore, now I go do something else. No, you've got something of value there that can be carried right over into the operations phase, and so it's well worth holding on to and using. Another key to this is that because we used a standard, and for us it happened to have been a mill standard, but it didn't have to be. It can be whatever standard you want to pick. There's a lot of commercial packages out there you can use. But those were levied universally across three major contractors and a multitude of subcontractors underneath them, such that everybody was taking that supportability data and packaging it in the same way, using the same data formats and the same conventions, such that even though data was developed at Huntington Beach, California, and at Huntsville, Alabama, it all went into the same data set, and when the flight controller in Houston looks at it, it doesn't look any different to him, no matter where it originally came from. It's standard, and it's all the same to him, and it greatly reduces the overhead of having to turn that into a maintenance procedure.